In this video, we will discuss pressure in non-moving fluids and also derive the hydrostatic equation. First off, pressure is generally defined as force per area. It has units of newtons per square meters, which is also known as a pascal, named after the French physicist Blaise Pascal. There are several other units to describe pressure, but this is the SI unit. If we consider a non-moving fluid, pressure is the same in all directions. To see this, look at this infinitesimally small volume of fluid. It does not move, so the net force acting on this volume is zero. This means the force from the left is the same as the force from the right, and so on. And this also means that the pressure on the left and right sides of this infinitesimally small volume is the same. Therefore, pressure is a scalar quantity. It has no direction. This is the same as temperature. If you measure temperature at one point in a room, there's no direction, if everything is in equilibrium. But if pressure is a scalar and force is a vector, how does this equation even work? To be precise, we should specify that we're only considering the component of the force vector perpendicular to the area. So in this equation, the symbol F is just one component of the force vector, not the whole vector. Let us now find out how the pressure changes at different positions inside a fluid. We will find that the pressure in the fluid is directly proportional to the depth at which we're measuring the pressure. Consider some volume of the fluid, which is now not infinitesimally small anymore. This means there is a downward acting force due to gravity, since this volume of fluid has some mass m. Furthermore, we also have two more vertical forces, one from the fluid above pushing down, and one from the fluid below pushing up. Now, since the fluid is still non-moving, these forces have to balance and result in zero net force. The forces from the fluid can be written as pressure times area, and the mass in the gravitational force can be written in terms of density and volume, where h1 and h2 denote the upper and lower bounds of the volume. Rearranging this equation yields the hydrostatic equation. Note that this derivation was quite simple because we assumed a constant density of the fluid. If the density would change inside the fluid, we would get an exponential behavior, like in the case of the barometric formula. Also, if you investigate the forces in the horizontal direction, you will find that the pressure does not change. If we set H1 to 0, then P1 is the atmospheric pressure from the air above the fluid, and the equation simplifies a bit. The important thing here is that this equation only depends on the depth inside the fluid. So even if we imagine various different shapes of fluid containers, if the fluid is filled up to the same height, the pressure at the bottom will be the same for all containers. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.